Welcome back to Let's Play Baldur's Gate Enhanced Edition Blind. I took the impetus, I don't know, to rest off screen, sell our stuff. We have a lot of money right now. Not sure what we'd spend it on since we have potions and stuff. But anyway, rested once and memorized Identify so we can figure out what this wand is. I was close. I thought a wand of fire balls. It's a wand of fire. Or it says the wand will cough forth a huge burning ball of fire. So it is, in effect, a wand of fireball. Streaks out to the desired range to a maximum 90 feet and bursts in a fiery, violent blast just like the fireball spell. Fireball inflicts 66 points of damage, but all ones rolled are counted as twos. That's interesting. The victim may make a save versus wand in order to take only half damage. The second ability of the wand is akin to the spell Agonizar's Scorcher in that a column of flame will streak towards the victim, inflicting 66 plus 6 damage. Actually, more damage with the save versus wand for half. Okay, so you have an option. I wonder when you use it if you get, like, a dialogue box popping up. So we've got 12 charges on that. Wand of Frost, too. I've got some good wands here. I should try to remember to use them. Alright. Let's rest again to get our spells back.
You want some whiskey?
To the original configuration. Alright.
Alright.
Now we're headed for the Cloakwood. So close to the side here. It's 20 hours, though. Probably close to the friendly arm.
You have been waylaid by enemies and must defend yourself.
It's kind of annoying, like these guys, but we're going to be exhausted by the time we get there.
Go for the eyes, fool! Go for the eyes! Rask!
Sure.
Your life should
give us victory!
Go for the eyes, fool! Go for the eyes!
We left one. For the love of money. Getting banged up over here. Guess it's a good thing we'll be running from the friendly arm in. Seeing again, that's like a chunk, right? Kinda looks like a piece of armor, doesn't it? I guess we'll sell that. What is that? Jasper.
Alright. Why me?
Why not? So you're just resting here. We'll sell the Jasper gem. Really just coming to rest before our journey out. That sounded like Noober. Don't follow us, Noober. Just stay over there in Nashkel. We may never go again.
Gather your party before venturing forth.
I mean, I know she's a wizard, but I can't believe she got hurt by gibberlings of all things. Not only once, but twice. Another rest. All right.
Please, seek yourselves whatever you wish.
Don't mean to rest and run,
good
but
on you if you save the day.
We're gonna rest and run.
All right.
No matter what happens, we're always leaving at nighttime. What time is it? 12. It's probably still gonna be. Daytime when we get there. But supposedly someone said there's an inn there? I don't remember who told us that, but we can always rest there once we've found it. The Cloakwood. 8 hours. Much better. Doesn't it look just about equal in length?
I much prefer wooded regions, but one must be flexible in these times.
Okay. Aphriel says, you there! Stand still and explain yourself. Why does that have to explain to people? And who might you be? I'm Aphriel, a ranger in search of bandits. We have a common goal. We are the Group of Sapphire. The Group of Sapphire. The name Sapphire is well known to me. Well, I think I will believe you for the moment. To be honest, I could even use your help. We will listen to what you have to say. I thank you. I am looking for my son. Bandits have kidnapped him. Well, I hope he turns out better than the last son we found. Do you have a guess where he is? The Iron Throne's raiders have a base somewhere in the forest. I guess they keep him trapped there. Do you think that he is still alive? He simply has to live. He's my everything. And consider the bandits' demand a ransom for their hostage. Why do these people do such a thing? I was a ranger in this area for a long time until I retired a few years back with a local merchant in Baldur's Gate. We made some good money, and now the bandits are demanding a ransom we can't and won't pay. What a crime. We will help you. May the gods bless you, good man. Excuse me. I shall pursue my own search. We will meet at the Friendly Arm Inn when you have found out anything. Well, I suppose she's talking to Kagan. The elf Aphriel is looking for her son Perwell. Am I supposed to return to Gerd or something? Tell her what happened? Tell her I killed all the oncakes and then went down in her nest and killed all them too? The elf Aphriel is looking for his son Perwell in the Cloakwood Forest. The bandits have kidnapped him and apparently took him to a secret location. Now there's someone else. Is it Girk? Who's looking for a cloak in the Cloakwood. I remember that because it's just apt. Yeah, the Fabula goes to Baldur's Gate. I think some of these we can't really conclude. Yeah, just like there forever. A journal from a dwarf named Bashrik, right. We've got some quest to turn in Baldur's Gate, but Prism. We need to find him. Girk's cloak. A crusty old dwarf in Baraghost has had his supposedly famous cloak stolen from him from a batch of Tasloi in the Cloakwood. Huh. After our brief encounter, I've come to the conclusion I'd do almost anything to rid him of that sour mood. Alright. Yeah, we have some stuff from Olcaster. That's Olcaster. This we have to find. I'm still waiting to find an elixir of Belladonna at some point. The quest for Perwell. Mm.
Sure.
What does the Cloakwood cloak, I wonder? Interesting rocks. Oh, here we got Tasloi. Maybe we'll find the cloak over here. There's a lot of them. Alright, that one's running, so...
My blade will cut you down to size!
Oh, you're many arrows. Oh, they keep running, so it's kind of annoying. Blue stone necklace.
All right.
Ooh, we got here some kind of magical cloak. Oh, that might be it. That might be it indeed. Stop running, damn you.
My right. Blade will cut you down to size.
Gotcha. That's a pretty cool looking cloak. What am I doing? Alright, I can't identify it yet. I think we found his cloak already, though. So we have a choice if we want to keep it or give it back to him. A lot of trees around here.
Die, Pipsqueak.
Haha, I know Grillin. Calling us Pipsqueak.
Alright, give us victory!
Oh, a whole bunch. Okay.
What?
I'm not. They're a little bit tough, I think, right? At least a little bit. You know what? Belay that order.
Yes.
You sleep. Sleep forever.
My blade will cut you down to size. Tempest, give us victory.
Go for the ice pool.
And finally, the moonstone gem. Have I found a moonstone gem yet? It's a silver ring, green stone ring. Moonstone is an opaque white feldspar gem polished to a bluish sheen. Old legends say that the sight of a moonstone would cause a lycanthrope to revert to her original form, her animal form. Sorry. Whether or not this is true is unknown, as anyone close enough to find out apparently hasn't lived to tell the tale. However, moonstones have been used in spells that affect this particular curse. Which would make sense, moons and all. Roll berries or belladonna. The corpse of Tonder. Who the hell's Tonder? Kagan says, I hand it to you, Sapphire. You don't look like much, but you have got the knack. Oh? What knack is that? Why, of minding other folks' business and making it pay. Ain't a finer trade in the land than that. I don't intend to keep an accounting ledger on this. Any goods will be used to further our efforts or sold for gear, which you will surely need before long. There's the right way of making good in the world, doubling up your investments time and again. I just hope we can cash out in good style by the end. So do I. Alright. So the Moonstone Gem can't even be used to help in that werewolf quest. Looks like a big area. We've got a ward.
Go for the eyes, boo.
And where there's one, there's undoubtedly more. Oh boy. Time for another sleep spell. Does she know sleep? I think she can't use it. Sleep. I wonder if it would work on them. Actually, they're magical. Let's give it a try.
For the love of money.
All these things fell asleep on us.
Tempest, give us victory!
Ooh. That is dangerous. Sounds like Kagan got hurt. Oh, that thing's still awake? Hmm. I thought we'd put all of them to sleep. Okay. I guess that's what that long growl was.
Alright.
Well, let's... work our way around here. This is a big area. Huge spider. Joy.
Go for the eyes, Boo! Go for the eyes! Rask!
Boo is like, which eye? There's eight of them. Fitting spider combat theme. The strange, otherworldly, dangerous sound. Because when it comes right down to it, spiders are frickin' weird. Sweeping the area. Is this Aldeth Sashenstar? Well, pretty flowers, huh?
You there! Identify yourselves!
What purpose have you wandering this far into Cloakwood? Are you looking to earn some money? If you are, I'll be willing to pay a considerable amount for your assistance. I am Aldeth Sashenstar, a noble from the city of Baldur's Gate. Perhaps you have heard of me? No matter. I am looking for some good, strong people who could defend me against a band of savages. These ruffians have been threatening my companions and me with bodily harm. Would you be interested? Yeah, we're going to tell a yes or no, so yes, we would. Good. I'm glad you had the sense of decency to help a man in my situation. Let me explain my predicament. My friends and I come here every year to do some sport hunting. This year, however, a group of woodland savages threatened us with bodily harm if we did not stop our hunting trip. Being civilized men, we realize that it's well within our rights to hunt where we damn well please. After a few more days of hunting, the crass woodmen lost all pretense of humanity and murdered Elbin, one of my oldest friends. I'm sure that they plan to attack our cottage here, so we had best be prepared. Oh. And here are those savages that they spoke of.
I have no quarrel with those who respect my forest.
Seniyad says, "Trespassers and butchers of our wood, I, Seniyad, have come to administer the punishment that you have brought down upon yourselves. Yet, who are the ones that stand beside you? With them we have no quarrel. It is now to you that I speak. These men have most likely duped you into protecting their sorry hides. They have most likely not told of the druid that they have slain in cold blood. I will allow you to rethink your earlier decision and leave these men to their most deserved fate." Aldeth says, "Do not listen to these slavering wild men, my dear friends. They lie as befits the uncultured barbarians that they are." Hello, Varabalm. "Don't you think you're being rather harsh, Seniyad? We can't just let you murder Aldeth. Come now, why don't we come to a peaceful solution?" "You have made your choice, fools. Now you will suffer together with your hunter friends." Oh boy. I wasn't really taking his side. I just wanted to come to a different solution, but now we have to kill you. I mean, when it comes right down to it, I'd probably take the side of these guys over the... over the, you know, the crass noble over there. Oh boy, I have a feeling we're gonna regret this. And Aldeth is just leaving. That's wonderful.
I don't wanna talk.
For right. I always...
Flame Blade. Okay, Druid. So that's Seniyad himself. Druid. And Druid. I wonder... I'm out of sleep spells anyway. A fireball has a wide range. Maybe here?
Go for the eyes! Go for the eyes!
Fine.
Alright, my spell was interrupted anyway. Alright, we got...
Go fetch to someone else.
My blade will cut you down to size.
I think we got him down, right? This is just... Oh, Seniyad is still kicking. Okay, is that... I think that's held. I actually killed him with a... Well, I guess some kind of magical ring.
What is it?
Alright, so all our fighter types are held.
My blade is cutting down their side.
Takes care of that. I give you my gratitude for the aid you have given us. If you ever travel to Baldur's Gate, come to the Merchant's League estate, and I will aid you in any way I can. Take now this small token of my appreciation. I feel bad for having done this, but it's kind of like self-defense. These guys just attacked us when I wanted to reason with them. Oh well. I dropped an item on the ground. We've got to pick it up. Aldeth Sashenstar was so grateful that I fended off the druids that he invited me to visit him at his house in Baldur's Gate. Tarum. I'm in chapter 4, so this is him. Yeah, right, I killed the woman's undead husband. She should be able to live in peace now. Yeah. What do we drop? I gotta wait for this stuff to... Who's that?
Such menial tasks.
So what do we pick up? I can't... We got this off of what's his name. So what did the guy give us? Maybe he just gave us a potion or something. Oh, he just gave us a potion of heroism. That's all he did. Welcome back, guys. One more. Well, that was exciting.
Sure.
I'm glad you agree. Let's take a look in here. These guys just left. They ran back to Baldur's Gate.
Sure.
Apparently so.
All right, all right.
Ooh. Okay.
A simple matter.
A rainbow obsidian necklace. An elixir of health. 395 gold. A potion of invulnerability. This potion confers very high resistance to all attacks while giving bonuses to all saving throws. It can only be used by those trained in the martial arts.
Sure.
And then we've got two kind of magical arrows.
Fine.
All right, so this is... Oh, this is... He's holding it. I think someone else has an elixir of health. Arrow of Fire plus 2. I've been having Branwyn hold on to the special arrows once identified. Arrow of Ice. No, I had some of those. Arrow of Piercing. Yes, I had no idea. So many different kinds of arrows. So many options. It's good to have options, but... And I have this magical ring. This potion of heroism? Yeah, let's just stack it over here. Get to checking out that ring eventually. Cabin. See what other kind of trouble we can get into over here. A dread wolf. A few of them. Oh, what?
Whatever they need. No less than done.
You're really tempted to come over to us. But that's a bad dog to do that. Oh boy. Either that or he's chasing the squirrel. Sapphire leveling up. That's what I love to see. Entering level 6. Darts. Additional weapon proficiency, so... Quarterstaff is kind of tempting. The whole mage fighting with a quarterstaff has a certain appeal to it for me, but mages are best staying out of melee combat, so I'll take dart. I can use it with no penalties. If we get enough darts, eventually I might take some of Minsk darts and use them for myself. Now what about spells, I can know an additional level 3 spell. Okay, so we've got Fireball already. Detect Illusion, Dire Charm, Dispel Magic, Fireball. Another Fireball, rather. Flame Arrow, Ghost Armor, Lightning Bolt, Non-Detection, Remove Magic, or Spell Thrust. Mage Armor, if I remember right, gives you 2 armor plus 2. That could be helpful. But I think as a general all-purpose thing, it's good to... Normally, anyway, I don't know about... In Baldur's Gate... It's always good to have Dispel magic. Eventually, cloud kill. So whenever I rest next time, I'll have that as well.
A simple matter.
How about not running off by yourself?
All right.
I know you just went up a level. Don't get cocky here. Oh. Or Tasloi.
My blade will cut you down to size.
Go for the ice, boy! Go
victory.
For the ice!
For right!
Bark like a dog for me.
Name it.
Go for the ice, boy!
Give us
go
victory!
You're kicking and mumbling. What am I doing? Does the cloak would have to throw at us? Water. That water looks beautiful, doesn't it? What you got? Another huge spider.
Name it.
A bunch. I'm glad they're not poisoning us.
Your life.
Tis a fine day to die.
Why me?
No dying, no dying. Clear out this fog of war here. Okay. See anything in the trees behind the cabin here? Probably not. Ah! Another dread wolf and friends. Action, adventure, thrills. Damn wolves.